Hello, everyone. We're coming to you this evening with breaking news regarding space travel and life on other planets. It has been reported that around 7 p.m. last night, alien visitors from the planet Mars landed right here in Bethel Park. Apparently, these alien visitors made their way to the Bethel Park Public Library, where they not only stumbled upon books, but learned all about their summer learning program. The Mars inhabitants were greatly impressed with the program, and so much so that it seems they want to take information back to Mars in hopes of replicating the system there. Our news correspondent, Sarah Runco, is at the Kennedy Space Center now, talking to NASA personnel about the landing. Sarah, history was made last night if what we are hearing is indeed true. Can you confirm, after speaking with NASA officials, that life on Mars does indeed exist and that visitors from the planet arrived here yesterday?
That's right, Elaine. History was made yesterday, and staff here at NASA, including its senior astrobiologist, have confirmed the landing. Scientific evidence was taken from West Library Avenue in Bethel Park and immediately brought down here to Florida for examination. Parts of the spacecraft are being studied as we speak, and one extraterrestrial has been brought here to NASA and is in questioning with a NASA administrator. Communication is slow, but they are making progress with the Martian, whose name appears to be Yaba. What we do know is that Yaba was greatly impressed with what he saw at the Bethel Park Public Library. He expressed his excitement by jumping up and down and twirling his antennae in rapid circles. It seems that these new visitors are friendly, docile creatures who intend no harm.
Well, this certainly is amazing stuff. So hard to believe and exciting for sure. Sarah, our viewers are also hearing that this recent encounter has prompted NASA officials to go ahead and launch the Apollo sooner than they had expected. They are just so eager to now visit Mars and learn about their land and their inhabitants. Can you confirm Apollo's pending launch, and has that been moved up?
Yes, that's right. NASA worked throughout the night to prepare for the mission to Mars, and I had the opportunity to speak with one of the astronauts, Miss Christine McIntosh.
Hey, it's Christine McIntosh coming to you from the surface of Mars. I am so excited to be part of this inaugural landing on this planet. In all the years that I worked and trained with NASA, I never thought for a minute that I'd ever get to do something as incredible as land on Mars. I've seen some really great stuff here. They have a really fun water park. Their pizza is great. But I do understand why they want to come to Earth to visit our library. They have libraries, but they don't have any Miss Elaine's or Miss Sarah's or Miss Jackie's or any of the other wonderful resources that we have.
Well, again, everybody, just incredible news here today. Sarah, we thank you for your extensive coverage down there at the Kennedy Space Center. Thank you to Christine for the interview. We can only imagine how busy this time must be for you as you prepare for your new and exciting adventure. Sarah, we'll look forward to more coverage and speaking with you again on the 6 o'clock news. We're going to toss it over now to Kristen Slavonic, who's actually at the Bethel Park Public Library, the first location that the aliens explored. Kristen, what were the reactions of the library staff, and have you caught any glimpses of the Martians yourself?
Well, as you can imagine, Elaine, the staff were just dumbfounded by the whole situation. One person reportedly fainted and was transported to the hospital, but they have been reported to be okay and have been released. Now, all the staff that I did speak to were just surprised on what to do in this situation. They did say that communication was very difficult with the extraterrestrials, but they and the aliens ended up using hand gestures and body signals to communicate with each other. Now, children's staff member Lynn Hahn had this to say about her encounter.
I worked here for almost 25 years, and I thought I'd seen it all until I saw green Martians come in, and I thought they were green lizards that came in from the garden.
Two of the little Martians were preoccupied with the vast amount of toys in the play area. A few were engrossed in their books, but all were eager to learn more about summer learning. Their excitement could barely be contained, and library staff were thrilled to give them more information.
I've worked here for almost 6 years, and I thought that those Martians were roofers on top of the building.
Well, it sounds as though that library staff will have quite the stories to tell for years to come. Now, no one has actually seen the extraterrestrials leave the area, so some do believe that they may still be around. All of the aliens seem friendly and harmless, so should you run into one, do not be afraid, but please do call the NASA hotline at 555-555-5555. We're going to interview some local residents now to see if they agree with the Martians' take on summer learning. Some Earthling students have been badging at the Bethel Park Public Library for the last couple of years, and they're here today to share their thoughts.
Okay, I grew up in Bethel Park and I grew up coming to the library. Now my kids get to come and enjoy it, just like I did as a child.
I come with my mom and it's very fun being with my mom.
I am very happy to be here, and the most wonderful thing about the library is it has lots of books and words in the books and so many wonderful pictures.
Books could just take you anywhere.
It's been a foundation for early literacy in their lives, and it's really shown as they've grown up, and now they're 9 and 5 years old, and they love reading and they love being a part of everything that goes on here at the library.
I love at the library because they are nice.
We know all the librarians by heart. We know everybody's names and we feel like a family here.
I like how it has lots of programs, including the summer reading program.
We love the summer reading program because there's always great ideas in the booklets and suggestions from the librarians about activities and things to do.
We love the library because it's so much more than the books. They have classes for kids of all ages.
Whether it's a summer reading program or any of the programs, we try to do as many of the activities as possible. And we feel that the library is a valuable resource in our family's life. And we wouldn't really know what to do without it.
It's really good for kids to be here too.
Checking out books, reading books, learning how to read, and all these wonderful experiences I can do at the library.
We're very thankful for our library, and we're glad it's such a vital part of our lives.
12, 11, 10, 9, ignition sequence start, 6, 5,